2 of The Awakening, The Heartbreak, okay? Yeah, this is basically what everybody's been dying to know, okay? The heartbreaking process was the, what they call, dark night of the soul, okay? But, the heartbreak process is the truth. The truth that I had to realize within my life is the betrayal. People that you can sleep with can mean you no good, okay? People that you can sleep with don't mind telling all your business. People that you can sleep with can do a triangular effect in your life. And what that means is talk to somebody else about you. I mean bad, like a dog, okay? The betrayal part. That's the betrayal that all of us readers are talking about. You know, either you was betrayed by talked about, you was betrayed by cheated on, you was betrayed by all your secrets being thrown out there, you was betrayed by your spirituality. That is the dark night of your soul, because my intuition immediately kicked in after I turned my ex away. I mean, it immediately kicked in. It was like I went to sleep and it was like everything was lifted off from me, but here comes the universe and spirit talking to you. Okay, well, he's going to say this and he's going to say that. It was just like my angels automatically kicked in, because that was, have you ever been so heartbroken that you don't even know where to go, how to do, what to do? You just stay in bed and you're stuck. Like, oh my God. Well, I was in that oh my God moment. And the whole time I felt my angels, my mom passed like 5 years ago. I felt her kiss me on my forehead and I heard her say, it's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. Cry about it, scream about it, fight about it, sleep about it, do whatever you need to do, but it's going to be all right, okay? So that was like a real crucial dark night of the soul for me, because I stopped eating. Tristan had just turned 1. I'd say he was like 14 months. I didn't have a job. He was our supporter. He was our everything. He was my everything, you know what I'm saying? Cook, clean, I did everything for him. I took me out of it and put him in my place. So I lost myself. I could truly say you lose yourself through things like that. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, when you do your dark night of the soul, your truth comes out, okay? Their truth and yours, okay? I was not loving myself. I was not putting myself first. I forgot what worth was. Worth, what was that? You know what I'm saying? I allow people, places, and things. I allow drugs. I allow drinking. I allow all kinds of things to overpowering. Smoking cigarettes was one of them. Even though I do vape, yes, I do. But I allow different things to run and rule my life. I was not controlling the situation when it came to me. And I knew better. You know what I'm saying? But that's what that dark night does. That dark night brings everything up. It brings your past up. It brings your childhood woundings up. It brings your abandonmentship up. It brings everything up. And I prayed and I cried out to God in my room. And I said, you know, something has to change. And that's when, like, maybe 3 or 4 days, I began my dark night of the soul process. Now, some people, dark night of the soul can last a week. It can last 2 weeks. Mine lasts 30 calendar days. It was like everything that was around me, I was talking to my good friend at the time, and I was like, this is happening, and that's happening, and I'm feeling this, and I remember this, and I'm, you know what I'm saying? I think every demon that was a part of me, including sexuality, everything to try to just take off, and I knew that I was not driving. The devil was actually driving the wheel, okay? And when you come to that acknowledgement, that's a scary thing. That is a heartbreak by itself, okay? And I allow narcissistic behavior to just walk right through my door. I shared that, you know, with narcissistic behavior. It's called a trianglership, okay? It's when somebody that you care about turn everybody against you, but what they didn't know, not even him, but God. One thing being a chosen one is you can't take on who you are. That's for sure. I've never been the in crowd kind of person, okay? So you telling somebody else about me, let me tell you, girl, I can tell you about me, okay? And I didn't know at the time that I was a chosen one, But I knew that I could tell you about me, the good, the wrong, the bad, and the ugly, okay? There was nothing that you couldn't possibly say about me. Where he, in the situation, could have knocked my, what they call it, self-esteem, it didn't. Because I knew about my bad, I knew about all that. So by the time the news got to me, I didn't care, okay? I was full force of worried about me, fixing me. And that's what happens when you go through the dark night of soul. You take your mind and your criteria off of everybody else. Yes, yes. You take your mind. It's gum, though. One piece, a piece. You take your mind off the arteria of what somebody else doing right or wrong, and you get you together. Okay, God just shapes you up. Spirit just shapes you up and say, hey, this is you. This is what's happening. This is your behaviors. This is what's going on. And all of it has broke your heart. So when you're looking in the mirror and you're saying to yourself, he broke my heart. No, actually, you broke your own heart. Think about it. How many mistakes and choices have we made out of life to where we broke our own heart? Because you knew better to knew better to do better, right? We broke our own heart. I even had my children driving the car. Everybody drove the car. Everybody had the keys except me. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's funny now, but it wasn't funny then because I was in tears. I mean, all this goes on with the dark night of the soul. You know, all this goes on. You know what I'm saying? Your initial heartbreak right there. Just in your lap. You know what I'm saying? But God, you know, Spirit takes control of you when you're ready to admit. The first thing is to admit to things are out of control. You got to admit to it. And not only do you admit to it, you know what's out of control. You gotta point blank, okay, I was manipulative. I shouldn't have said this. I should apologize here. I shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have asked for that. I should have, you know, things start to come in place. You know what I'm saying? For you. Of the things that you shouldn't have been doing wrong. I shouldn't have slept with that person. I should have kept myself quiet. You know, and it's all a part. The dark night of the soul is a scary thing, but it's all a part of working on you. You know, you haven't even got to the healing part. No, that's not healing. Your dark night of the soul is not healing. It's basically putting everything in your lap that you know that was not in line with the universe, with God or whoever you serve. And that's the second part of your awakening. The first part is being awake. The second part is your dark night of the soul. Okay? And I sit back and I think about it to this day. I'm like, wow, that was the worst day of my life. But that needed to happen. In order for you to change, you got to notice what you are changing. You can't allow people to say, oh, I changed. Oh, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. What did you change? You know what I'm saying? If you ask me right now, the things that I've changed, I can tell you. And not only can I tell you, I walk in. You know what I'm saying? You could see. You don't need to print out flyers. You don't need to paste stuff on Facebook or stuff like that. I'm a real introvert. You know, this is the real me. I let you know what I want you to know. You know what I'm saying? Kind of person. But now I don't care. I never have cared. My job and my leadership that God wants me to walk is more important than anything of the soul. So if I can humiliate myself to help you out, by all means. You know what I'm saying? By all means. I stand up to the plate. I surrender that. And I can only do that, and you can only do that, if you go ahead and go through the dark night of the soul. It's the worst, but it's the best thing of your life. It will definitely change your life. It will definitely identify all the wrongs that you've done in your life, okay? And that's what you want to do, because it's so quick to say, but they, they didn't. Now, granted, you don't betray yourself, okay? And let's take that off the table. Everybody plays their part. I have secrets that I've had from high school. I would never tell anybody, you know what I'm saying? But he did. Most of them were lies. 20% was truth. His family knew about it. Half of them, how they say, 85% were lies. 10% was true. But when you're going through the dark night of soul, you don't care. You don't care what's true or lie. You don't care if they like you or not. But that's a trianglership, and that's what narcissists do. They put you in a triangle affair. So if you are in a triangle affair, that's okay. Go through the dark night of soul, write it, talk it, or even cry it out. You'll get through it. I did, and so will you. Part 3 is up next.